Hello friends of the Nova Entertainment and welcome to another episode of On The Road. As you know, On The Road, whenever you see an episode of this, it's because there was some kind of update that I felt was worth our while. And today is one of those days. The update is out for a little bit now and I'm a little bit behind the eight ball. But we'll do our best here to get you caught up on everything. So what happened in the last update was they added multi-recasting to the wheels. Now if you are not in game development or have anything to do with physics application, I will show you what that exactly means. Now what they did also was they changed the field of view on the mirrors as well as brightened the lights, which is something. If you remember the last episode, I was saying that I do hope we get brighter lights soon. Because what they have right now is just not doing it. The turn signals are still way too dark. But at least you can see them on the back now, and they do have a little bit of a sheen to it. They actually illuminate the surroundings, so that's nice. And if we look at the lights themselves, let me first of all get the ignition on here. There we go. And now let's get some light. Then you can see that now you can actually see the lights being illuminated, which is a really nice little feature that I was missing. And that's really nice. So yeah, what else did they change? They changed something on the interior. The interiors are more... Yeah, more detailed now, way more detailed in fact, and they will show a lot of differences between the XLX and XLL cabs that are coming. And but that said, let's just go here. I'm pretty sure we are in Hamburg, so let's grab Easy Tank Hamburg to Truck Service Hamburg. Sure, why not? Good. Let's do this. Oh yeah, here you see Dortmund is the next one and Leipzig are being worked on. And if you think about the fact that this is almost twice the scale of European Truck Simulator in terms of the map in-game compared to real life, where trucks, where ETS is 1 to 20, this one is 1 to 10. That is significant if you think about the fact that this map has to be rendered and the sheer amount of area that has to be covered. Of course, that makes for really big cities too. I mean, how many cities do you know in... And I know, I again compare this to Euro Truck Simulator, but you have to. How many times do you see three or even four gas stations within one city? How often do you drive for 5-10 minutes and you are still in the same city? Not that often. I know there's a few cities in there that can, but or that have exactly that. But yeah, it is just it. Oh, by the way, in case you're wondering, this was already the we already picked our load up, because where we were standing there to fuel up just happens to be also the place where we get our load. And that is still, that is the same mechanic that I personally think that should be changed. That being, thank you. That being stop. A little bit too harsh there. The mechanics how you get your loads, I think, is still something. I mean, let's not forget this is early development too, so okay. Well, next thing I'm waiting for really is Track IR support. That would make my day. I can tell you that much. Because this whole thing with having to move my mouse to move the head in game is not quite working for me, but if you really think about it, you know, we had a lot of concerns with we had a lot of concerns with sound and whatnot initially, and I was the first one to admit that the sounds are subpar by any stretch of the imagination, but that light was red. Eesh. Sorry buddy, I have to back up a little bit. Nope, now it's green. Good. That poor dude that's behind me, he must be like, what is the problem here? Okay, now I messed up my... Now I messed up my shifter here. That was not helping. There we go. Oh yeah, I wanted to show you guys what the multi-ray casting is on the wheels. So I'm gonna show you. I never showed you really that because I never really tried it, but I never really had problems with it, I should say. But one of the things that was a problem is that if you try to drive up a sidewalk, for example, which why would you? But just in case you want to, if you try to drive up a sidewalk, then the vehicle would just grind along the sidewalk because the wheels would not independently off from each other act. Now, if you look at this, this is what the multi-ray casting is, and he just ran into our pit. That's cute. But you can see now how every wheel independently is actually acted upon. Oh yeah, another thing, now that I see the... there. So that is the change on that. But another thing that changed is... Really? Again? This gearbox is not cooperating today at all. But another thing that I forgot to mention is, with the latest iteration of the game, is the fact that AI traffic has now license plate. And this is just one of those little things that, nah, yeah, whatever. But if you want to make a simulator that is supposed to be called simulator, then you want to be keeping close eye on details like that. My turn. Thanks, buddy. Now, I have to be honest with you guys. I haven't been close enough to AI cars to see if they are actual license plates like you would find them, and they are different for the area, or if they are just made up license plates. Okay, where are we delivering? Oh no, we are picking up here, I think. So that wasn't the same gas station. I was wrong. I was totally wrong. Which happens every now and again. There we go. Okay, we got that. But yeah, this is, keep in mind, all this driving, this is one city still. So that is what I'm saying. If they would realize all of Europe, or even just all of Germany in that scale, that would give you a plenty to drive in. And that they are doing that, well, you can see that at the at the size of the cities. Now, I'm kind of curious how many cities they're gonna have, because what it stands to argue that because of the massive scale, really, if you think about it, and the detail in the cities. Now, I'm not talking about little tiny details in terms of things on the road and whatnot. And of course, this all has to come yet. People on the street and stuff like that. But I am talking more at this point about scale and a variety of buildings, details on buildings and stuff like that. Details in the city and in general design and structure. And by that, yeah, by that, you have to really ask how many cities can you really put in the game. And if we see now they work on Kassel and Dortmund, I think I just drove over a red light. It's not easy to have the commentary go and drive at the same time, at least not for me. But the thing is, as I said, it stands to argue that we won't have as many cities. I do hope I'm wrong, but if you have many cities, then the next thing is that comes to mind, how will the performance be? I mean, right now the performance is well, as far as I'm concerned. I mean, the mirrors are definitely came leaps and bounds from where they were in earlier versions of the game. But the question is, how much can you really do in this scale? How much can you put on before the performance becomes a real problem? Thinking this is the right way here? I'm not sure. Maybe? Maybe not. Yeah. Let's see. No, I should maybe get over here. Wow, that was an interesting road. And there are definitely some hiccups here that I notice. But then again, look at all those trees and everything, so my hopes are high for this sim, to be honest with you. Oh man, my hopes are not so high for my driving abilities. Now we're sitting at a red light, clearly. But we should be able to go right away because I just seen the... Oh, never mind. Now it's those guys' turn. Okay, well, I guess we'll wait. Oh, here we go. I should have had a sip of my tea while we were waiting. Now, things like, what I'm looking forward to too is to see, or what I'm looking forward to as well, is to see how things like hooking up to they are 53 foot, I have no idea how long they are in Germany, but they are a lot shorter than our 53 footers, but of course, how long. Or how well it works when you hook up to fifth wheel. How well that is simulated, how in-depth this all is. I still hope that we have to, at one point we see a truck simulator where you actually have to hook up the lines. That's one of my pet peeves, is that you don't have to do any of that stuff with any of them. And then pre-trip inspection would be nice if that has to be performed, or sorry, daily trip inspection, as it is now called, because it's no longer post and pre-trip, because technically you only have to do the inspection once per day, once every 24 hours, at least in Canada, of course. I'm not sure anymore about the requirements in Germany, it's been too long. But yeah, look at this, we are still, I can only say that again and again, we are still in the same city. We are still in Hamburg. And driving here to our destination. Coming here into the harbor. Another red light. And no, there is no right on red. In Europe. I don't know, I like the engine sound of this thing. Uh-oh. A little bit of a fender bender there. Are you gonna turn green before I arrive there? No, of course you're not gonna be turning green the second when I'm coming to a stop. No, never mind. Yeah. Alrighty. No, and another crash here. Oh, but that's good, because now I can have a look here at the... Oh yeah, what do you know? Those are actual Hamburg license plates. HH. Hansestadt Hamburg. And what else do we have here? That one is... I have to be... MD. Okay, that one I do not know anymore. But I'm just looking here at the license plates now. Because I'm curious. Well, plus I don't want to run into anything. Okay, well, I guess we just leave it at that. Off we go. This does remind me, however, at my reminds me a lot of my experience yesterday in Omsi, where I started the tour and the traffic was so bad that I was sitting there for 21 minutes. Before I even had the first passenger on board, I was already 21 minutes late. Man, was I impressed. And there is our delivery point, which of course we will back into. Especially since we have only a well, never mind. Damage, zero reputation, 40.4. Don't jump out of the truck like that. Thank you very much. Okay, good. Well, that was a nice little drive. I do hope you enjoyed it. And I will be back once we have more to show here, probably with straight and... actually, let's look in terms of vehicles. Yeah, we do have now Yeah, we do have them now. See, there's a tandem. There is a normal semi, box trailer, and then just a straight truck. And the trailers are coming soon. And with that said, trailers are coming soon is really, 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 really great, because that means that we get the economy system that I wanted for ETS the whole time. And maybe that is a signal for SCS to look into getting an economy system a little bit more advanced than what they have right now going. So there are hopes for that as well. But regardless, guys, I do hope you enjoyed the episode. If you did, please don't hesitate to smack that like button right into the face. And leave a comment if you feel inclined to do so. Let me know what your hopes, dreams, wishes are for this game. And the next time, yeah, we will see how much the developers did. Because it's quite a bit of... oh, what is a giga line? Whoa, 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 what? That's... Ooh, look at that. Wow. I did not know that. Nice. Yeah, that is quite a machine. But anyways, guys, as I said, hope you enjoyed the episode. And this is the Nova Analytics signing off. God bless.